All right. We're killing baddies. I'm in my power suit. Whoops. We're doing cleansing the Commonwealth. Easy set of missions where all you had to do is kill things. And that's it. Well, I'm eating pizza as well. Which is always a plus. Alright. We got this guy, Paladin Dance. He's got power armor, so he's pretty tough. Alright. Let's get in there. You know, just kill everyone. Get out of here. Hello.
The children of Adam are strangely resistant to radiation.
Oh shit! That scared the crap out of me. yeah, just take your time. You know, take it a little too. Bleed, you filth. That was easy. I expected like raiders and stuff. Alright. Paladin Dance.
Need something?
Wait. Oh, I have to go. Okay, I remember this. Alright. Thora, I got it. So if we go to this place, and then we turn in the quest, and we're good. Hopefully he gives us another similar quest. Alright, rather than waste my power core, I'm just gonna get out and walk it. Alright, let's see. What this guy wants.
So, are you finished or what?
Yeah, totally.
Affirmative.
Looks like I got my surprise for the day. Here's
yeah,
your
you
payment.
Did.
Commonwealth
yeah.
is a big place in need of some serious exterminating. Once you've prepped for your next mission, come find me.
I'm good. Let's go.
I'm ready.
Better be. Here's
Whoa.
The data on the location. Don't come
Attitude.
Back until the op's done.
This guy hates me. Just because I'm a knight.
Greetings, knight.
As well as him.
Heard you gave those muties at Ford Strong something to think about.
I used to be like you for like 10 minutes, and then I became a knight.
I haven't already seen it, which I did. So
really fast. I thought it took much more work to become a knight. I guess not. Anyone and everyone is becoming a knight. Look how clean this one is compared to the other one.
Glad you're back, Nick. Even though we never really talk. Like, ever.
Fritteruni Hall.
Hey, you like Louis Jordan, right? Well, here's a classic from him.
Good neighbor. Oh, I haven't discovered that yet. How do you take off? There we go. I was wondering how you took them off. Like, dog is barking. Shut up. Look at those deer. Hi, we're deer. This is Ted. And I'm Bill. Yeah, we share the same body. It gets rough out there. We gotta eat twice as much. And it's really easy to overeat, too. You know, one stomach, two heads. Yeah, sometimes he pokes me in the eye, you know. Ted does, but we get along. And that was our little conversation.
That's what I call locked and loaded.
What the fuck did I do? I didn't do anything. I just spawned, and he liked that? Alright, whatever.
Every map of this area we've recovered has the common marker. I'm not gonna make this easy for you.
What's up, fool? How does the Brotherhood do it? Huh? How did the fucking Brotherhood do it? Idiot, save it. You're not stupid, just different. So apparently luck is amazing now. Oh, I get it. This is the agility. I got a lot in strength. Then show everyone with your gun, aim it in a pumbo. To pacify it? Damn. That is quite the charisma. Why does the sun feel shining? Why does the sea rush the shore? Don't they know it's the end of the world? You can reload guns 25%. I deserve. Fuck, this isn't. I shouldn't be doing it like that. I should have been raising my special stats. He's an animal, right? Oh, I have to select them as in. Oh, crap, so I can accidentally. Well, I didn't know that. They're zombies. Confirmed. Oh, that's cool. I want to go up there later, though. What's up? What's up, buddy? Just chilling, having a break. Well, now you're gonna die, so. Hope it was fun living when you were alive, you know? Oh my god. Yeah, just. Oh, they can jump. This gun is pretty good. I'm not scared. Come at me, bruh. You won't come at me.
I don't think we're alone.
Oh shit.
You humans made us! Now suffer for your arrogance!
Wow, he's pretty smart. He said arrogance. I've never heard any of them say that word. Whoa, whoa, buddy. Before you shoot at me. Scrub. Get that shit out of here. Oh, there's more. Whoops, nope. I don't want to do that. I like how I don't have this freeze time. It makes things a little faster. Like, I wouldn't take in that. I'm pretty good with what I got right now. In terms of, weapons. They only have .38 rounds. Which sucks. What the fuck is good, neighbor? I need to go through here. Is this like an actual place where people don't die? Please tell me this is like not super mutant camp. Free your mind. What? Who's that? I'll walk around for this one.
Hey, hold up there. First time in Good Neighbor? You can't go walking around without insurance.
Insurance?
Insurance?
That's right. Insurance. Personal protection, like. You hand over everything you got in their pockets, or accidents start happening to you. Big, bloody accidents.
Time out. Someone steps through the gate the first time, they're a guest.
Holy shit. Do you see that?
You lay off that extortion crap.
What do you care? He ain't one of us.
No love for your mayor, Finn. I said let him go.
Oh.
Soft Hancock. You keep letting outsiders walk all over us. One day, there'll be a new man.
Ooh.
Man, this is me we're talking about. Let me tell you something.
If you found out a...
Oh my god! Holy shit!
Go and say that, huh? Breaking my heart over here.
Damn,
brother.
I guess. You can write a song about it.
Thanks for taking care of him.
Good. Now don't let this incident taint your view of our little community. Good neighbors of the people, for the people. You feel me? Everyone's welcome.
Yeah, I feel you.
Good. You stay cool, and you'll be part of the neighborhood. So long as you remember
what?
Who's in charge.
What do you mean? Why are you mad? Because we didn't that guy did me a service. Dance. The mayor helped me. This guy was going to take my money, so the mayor killed him.
Whoever this Brotherhood of Steel is, I'm not buying that you come in peace malarkey. You step through the gate, you got balls.
Nice fat man.
Well, hello.
Hi.
Everything here is guaranteed to injure, maim, or kill at your discretion. Except me. I only kill when I want to.
What are you?
Who? What are you?
I'm a woman, baby. Can't you tell?
Yes.
Oh, of course you are. It's just all those metal plates. You're a robot, right?
A very
womanly robot?
Designation Assaultron. Designed to provide a variety of security-related tasks to the modern man. Runtime conclusion. Why work for the man when you can work for yourself? New designation. K-L-E-O. Cleo. Fully independent small business owner. Robot Damn. Enough for you, smooth talker. Now what are you buying?
Assaultron.
An Assaultron?
That's what my maker has called me. But as far as I'm concerned,
I'm a woman.
And I run a store that sells a bit. So Ooh. What'll it be?
What's for sale?
So what kind of weapons do you have?
Anything that can kill a man, I sell.
But
except suicidal depression. That is unfortunately not packageable. Now, are we doing business?
Yes.
Let's see what you have.
Each weapon tested on someone who deserved it.
Ooh. Harsh. I like that. She says she has big weapons. This does pretty good damage. I'm thinking about buying one of these. Flamer, I like that. Flamer looks cool. Double barrel shotty. Party starter. Plasma pistol, pull Q. I gotta upgrade my weapons. I keep forgetting to do that. Scatter boosted blazer rifle. Snub nose, tactical excited laser rifle, tactical light pipe revolver. So pipe guns are crap. I mean, they're okay. But they're the bottom of the bin when it comes to things like. Damn! Oh, those are Cryer cells. I was like, why the fuck is it so expensive? E-cells? Really? You guys don't have any? Damn, 400, no, I can't afford that. Wait, the fusion cells, for these, they need cells. Fusion cells, is that what they need? Or they just need cells? I think, I don't know. Either way, I need ammo for this gun. 45. Oh, she's got a lot. I don't need that much. I need to make more caps. Cancel, reset. And then, what if we bought? I want to lower the fucking prices of this. Jeez. I mean, these are expensive. No thanks. I think we can find our own ammo. Neighbor, good neighbor is what this place is called. Memory Den. The Memory Den. Okay, I'm gonna be right back. I'm gonna get something to drink. Alright. I've returned. Let's check out what this memory then is. Kinda got bad, sidetracked. But it's okay. Ooh, cool.
I thought you had forgotten about the lonely.
May have walked out of the den, Irma, but I'd never walk out on you.
Nick, what are you doing here?
Amari's downstairs, you big flirt.
Hey, Valentine.
Let's go talk to Amari.
Oh. I guess we ran into another quest. Why not? Damn it. I hope nothing I say makes him mad. You know the Brotherhood. Hardhead. Can't accept change no matter what. Must stick to policy. No flexibility.
Dr. Amari?
Yes. I take it this isn't a social call.
We need your help, Doctor. I need the memories from a man named Kellogg. But he's dead.
I know it's asking for a miracle, Amari. But you've pulled off the impossible before.
Are you too mad? Putting aside the fact that you're asking me to defile a corpse. You don't realize that the memory simulators require intact, living brains to function.
Please. Nick told me you're the only one who can make this work.
This dead brain had inside knowledge of the Institute, Amari. The biggest scientific secret of the Commonwealth. You need this, and so do we.
Fine. I'll take a look. But no guarantees. Do you have it with you?
Yes. Here you go.
Here's what I could find.
Synthetic brain.
This isn't a brain. This is... Wait. That's the hippocampus. And this thing attached to it? A neural interface?
Those circuits look awfully familiar.
I'm not surprised.
Yeah.
From what I've seen, all Institute technology has a similar architecture.
Go on, Doctor.
Mr. Valentine is an older generation synth. But Institute technology being what it is, the brain implant could fit him. But that's an incredible risk to take. We're talking about wiring something to his brain.
Don't worry about me, Amari. I'm well past the warranty date anyway.
I appreciate this, Nick.
You can thank me when we've found your son. All right.
Oh, I like this guy. I really like Valentine. Bro, this guy is like Raul.
If I start cackling like an old grizzled mercenary, pull me out, okay?
Let's see here.
We know Puerto Rican pull out here. We go all in, baby.
I need you to keep talking to me, Mr. Valentine. Any slight change in your cognitive functions could be dire. Are you feeling any different?
There's a lot of flashes. Static. I can't make sense of any of it, Doc.
That's what I was afraid of. The mnemonic impressions are encoded.
Damn it. It
appears the Institute has one last failsafe. There's a lock on the memories in the implant.
What? A lock?
How do you lock memories?
The implant is encoding all the mnemonic activity in the hippocampus. Think of it like computer encryption, and we don't have the password.
Damn it.
Let's see. A single mind wouldn't be able to crack it. But what if we use two?
What do you mean?
Load both you and Mr. Valentine into the loungers.
Yes.
Run your cognitive functions in parallel. He'll act as a host while your consciousness drives through whatever memories we can find.
So dirty. Let's do it.
Right. Let's get started.
Just sit down over there and keep your fingers crossed.
See you on the other side.
All right. Fallout 3, Tranquility Lane, here we come. That's what I'm guessing it'll be like. Hopefully. That's what I want it to be like. Hey, Ballad and Dance.
Initiating brainwave migration between the transplant and the host. Mnemonic activity coming from the transplant. It's degenerated, but it's there. We're going to load you into the strongest memories we can find. They might not be stable. Just hold on.
Tranquility Lane. What's up?
Can you hear me? Ah, good. The simulation appears to be working, although the memories are quite fragmentary.
Whoa.
I'll try to step you through the intact memories and hope we find one that gives us some clue to the Institute's location.
This is trippy.
There. This is the earliest intact memory I can find.
Cool. No trippy.
Turn down the goddamn radio! I'm trying to sleep! California Republic.
All five states have now signed off. Remember, you are experiencing these memories as Kellogg. This may prove disorienting at first.
Oh, so he's Kellogg.
What a joke.
Me.
What's it mean, Mom? Nothing, Connie. People like to talk and hope someone else is going to keep them safe.
Teacher at school said the NCR would bring back the good old days. Like before the big
war. NCR.
Don't you listen to that twaddle. I'm going to stop sending you if that's what they're teaching you.
I'm going out. Where the fuck did you put my boots?
Listen to me, Connie. You take this. You're old enough.
He's like seven.
You're the man of the family now. It's your job to protect us. Your father's useless, but you won't turn out like him. You're a good boy. And all that on the radio, all useless talk. The only thing that will protect you in this world is that gun.
His fucking legs are weird as hell. Really, Bethesda?
If you're going to survive.
I will, Mom. I promise.
Mom knew how it was. She wasn't soft, but she loved me in her way. And she protected me from Dad. That cost her more than a few beatings. I never knew what happened to her after I left. I didn't want to know. Not then.
We'll let you down.
I was such a dummy back then. What did I know about how the world worked? I think now she wanted me to kill him. I should have. Instead, I ended up running away. I told myself I wanted to find somewhere out from under the thumb of the NCR and all their rules.
Somewhere really, really far?
But really, I was running from the guilt of not protecting her from Dad. Yeah, it doesn't matter now, though.
This is depressing.
You've always been that good boy.
This doesn't seem to be what we're looking for. There appears to be another intact memory close to you in temporal sequence. There. Try that one.
Yay. This is awesome.
It's gonna be fine. You'll see.
But we don't know anybody here. And now, with the baby?
Come on, Sarah. You've got to give it a chance.
Who is this?
I finally got steady work with a good outfit. Nothing like that in the NCR these days.
Oh, it's me. I'm not saying this is Kellogg, a mistake. Technically.
I'm just... Are you sure these guys know what they're doing? They seem kind of green.
The thing about happiness is... you only know you had it when it's gone. I mean, you may think to yourself that you're happy, but you don't really believe it. Focus on the petty bullshit or next job or whatever.
Voice work.
It's only looking back by comparison with what comes after that you really understand that's what happiness felt like. I know, but that's where I come in. Just wait. In a few years, I'll be running my own crew. As soon as I make the connections I need. I was the worst thing that ever happened to her. If she'd never met me, she'd have stayed in the hub maybe hooked up with someone who didn't kill people hub? For a living. Probably been happier than she was with me. Almost certainly lived longer.
Then I can give you anything you want. And little Mary, too.
I never worried about you before. Must be my mama instincts kicking in. Who knew I had those, huh?
Come on, you're great with her. And you don't need to worry about me. Most of it's just running security for the Shi. A lot of standing around looking tough.
Whatever made me think that a guy like me should have a daughter? No, I never deserved her. Not for one second.
Well, they sure picked the right person for that job.
Listen, it's gonna be great here. See this? This is what's gonna keep you and Mary safe. I promise.
I know, Connie. I'm sure we're gonna be really happy here.
We are. You'll see. That's okay. I got it.
Let's keep looking. I'll connect you to the next intact memory.
This is Q. And kind of creepy.
How did you think this was going to end, Kellogg? You thought you could just fuck with us, and we wouldn't fuck with you? Just so you know, they died like dogs. And you weren't there to help them.
I found another memory to try. I'll connect you.
Whoa. There's some things we have to patch in the game. Oh. No, it's getting crazy. This is trippy.
Mind if we sit down?
Suit yourself.
I don't remember much from that time. It all kind of blends together. There was almost always a bar, though. That's universal.
So, I hear you'll take care of people's problems. Is that right?
There was always a job for someone like me. Didn't matter what it was. Didn't matter who I was supposed to kill. I got pretty good at it. If you pay me.
Oh, we'll pay you. And you'll do this all by yourself?
That's right.
We pay you when the job's done. Is that okay?
That's the way you want to do it. So who do you want dead?
Well, it's like this. There's his family. Lives down the creek a ways.
Well, we seem to be getting closer. Try this next one.
There's his family. You want the family dead? So somebody killed his...
Mr. Heller, I'm glad you decided to meet with me.
So, you're with the Institute. I wanted to see for myself if you really existed.
We do, as you can see.
What do you want?
It's come to my attention that you've been rather disruptive of our operations lately. This must stop.
I do what people pay me to do. If that's a problem for you, I can see only one way out.
And what's that, Mr. Kellogg?
If I'm working for you, there's no more problem. From what I hear, you can afford me.
I don't think you fully understand the situation you're in.
I think I do. I finally ended up in the Commonwealth. I kinda ran out of road. Plus, I'd come to terms with life.
I wasn't going to be stupid enough to get mixed up with caring about other people again. It was just me against the world. And the world had it coming.
He killed the wife.
You heard all sorts of rumors about the Institute. But I figured they were just a convenient boogeyman for anything bad that ever happened. They were real, all right. They didn't know anything about operating on the surface. Relied on their synths for everything. They had the resources I needed. And I had the expertise they needed. Turned into a permanent arrangement. Suited me just fine.
B-748, initiate.
First synths weren't all that impressive. I'm good, but I'm not that good. But the Institute could always make more. And kept making them better each time. They still give me the creeps, but you have to get used to them if you want to work with the Institute.
Hmm. Impressive. We may have something to talk about after all.
Getting warmer. One of these has got to tell us something. We're running out of brain here. Ah, there's one that looks mostly intact. Connecting now.
Manual override initiated. Cryogenic stasis suspended.
Vault computers are still working. That's good. Checking through the logs. Hopefully it's all...
Just... find it.
Pod C6. Down the hall near the end.
Ah, oh, so the Institute.
Eggheads never like taking orders from a dirty, contaminated degenerate like me. But they needed me. And I made sure they knew it.
Well, we killed you, so I don't feel that bad about you.
I was now the Institute's main operator in the Commonwealth. They needed something
That came to me.
Wasn't usual for anybody from the Institute to come along on a mission, so this one stood out. I didn't know then who it was we were grabbing from the vault. Of course, neither did they. Not really. Even then, I knew it was a mistake leaving him alive. I understood that kind of revenge. No one better. But I was cocky enough to assume I could handle some soft, pre-war vault dweller, even if he somehow got thawed out. At least I know those Institute bastards will soon get what's coming to them, too.
Ah, so he doesn't like the Institute.
If he could take me out, they won't be able to hide from him for long. I'm glad I didn't have to kill the kid. I'm not saying I haven't done it, but, I never like to. And yeah, I guess it did remind me of, her. Yeah, I'm a cold-hearted bastard for sure, but, still human. Better this way, though. Better than taking her kid and leaving her alive.
I don't know.
This is the one.
I never knew why we didn't just refreeze the rest of them. But we had our orders. I guess the old man didn't want so many loose ends. Too bad he left alive the one person he shouldn't have.
One. Here.
You could have killed me right then and there.
Open it.
Is it over? Are we okay?
Almost. Everything's going to be fine.
Come here. Come here, Pete.
No, no. I've got him.
Let the boy go.
I'm only gonna tell you once.
I'm not giving you Sean!
God damn it. Get the kid out of here and let's go. At least we still have the backup.
Cryogenic sequence reinitialized.
What's the holdup?
I'm almost finished, Kellogg. I just need to confirm. Come on. All right, we're good.
I'm sorry you had to go through that again. I found another intact memory. Whenever you're ready.
Oh, what the fuck?
Is that your son? This appears to be a very recent memory, so good news, I think.
This whole setup in Diamond City was part of some elaborate plan of the old man's. Seems obvious now that we were bait for our friend from the vault. Timing couldn't have been an accident. It's not how the old man works. I wonder if he outsmarted me in the end. Another loose end tied up. Wasn't my idea to settle down with the kid in the middle of Diamond City. I thought it was a terrible idea, actually. But it was one of the old man's pet projects, so here we were. Me and the kid. Like a happy little family. I ended up kind of liking it. A reminder of what my life might have been if things had turned out differently. But there's no going back. I knew it was just temporary. It'd be back to normal business before too long.
Kellogg. It's okay. One of these days you're gonna get your head blown off just barging in here like that. Minimizing.
The new breed of synths could easily pass as human. Some of them did. But the coursers, they weren't built to blend in. They were killing machines, pure and simple.
Ah.
Smarter, stronger, and faster than almost any real human. I'm just glad they were always on my side.
Cool.
My exposure to civilians is a priority.
Forget I said anything. So what's the big crisis this time?
New orders for you. One of our scientists has left the Institute.
Left? As in?
He's gone rogue. Name's Dr. Brian
Ooh.
Virgil. We know he's hiding somewhere in the glowing sea. Here's his file.
We gotta go find this guy. He's rogue.
Some heads are gonna roll for this. Capture and return, or just elimination?
Elimination. He was working on a highly classified program.
No kidding. One of the top bioscience boys? Damn. So, I guess you're taking the kid back with you.
Affirmative. Your only mission is to locate and eliminate Virgil.
You're taking me home to my father?
Yes. Stand next to me and hold still.
Okay.
What the fuck? Come on, Bethesda. Enough of this teleporting crap.
X688, ready to relay with Sean.
Relay.
Hi, Mr. Kellogg. I hope I see you again soon.
They can teleport? Whoa!
Bye.
What the fuck?
Teleportation. Now it all makes sense. Nobody's found the entrance to the Institute.
Whoa.
There is no entrance.
You need. Okay.
Let me get you out of there. As soon as you're ready.
That makes a hell of a lot more sense. Public consoles.
Slow movements, okay? I don't know what kind of side effects the procedure might have had. No one's ever done this before. How do you feel?
I'm okay, Doctor. Thank you.
That's good. But I want you to keep monitoring yourself. We have to be sure there's no long-term damage. Are you ready to talk about what happened in there?
There's more than one person who knows about the Institute. Virgil, that scientist who escaped.
I didn't know Institute scientists could defect. This changes everything. He could answer all sorts of questions. Where did the memory say he was? The glowing sea? That can't be right. No one would risk going there, not even to hide.
Why?
Why? What makes the glowing sea so dangerous?
The name says it all. Radiation. So much that nothing there could possibly live. Nothing pleasant. Navigating radioactive hazards is nothing new. But the glowing sea can kill a man in seconds. That's why it doesn't make sense. Virgil fleeing into that hell. The exposure alone.
He must be.
That's why he's there. To make the Institute think twice about following him.
That must be it. He's using the radiation in the glowing sea like a shield or a cloak, a way to throw them off and be at an advantage. If Virgil found a way to survive there, you'll have to do the same. If you're going to follow him.
Is there anything I can do?
How do I fight that much radiation, Doctor?
There are chemical compounds. Radex, Radaway. You'd need as much as you could carry. Maybe more. A sealed environment suit would be great, if you could find one. Or maybe one of those suits of power armor? That would be perfect.
Yes, I have those.
I'll find a way to get through the rads. Don't worry.
Good luck. And be safe. By the way, I unplugged Mr. Valentine first. Removed the implant while you were waking up. He's waiting for you upstairs.
Okay. Shit. All right.
Amari.
Be careful of the radiation. The glowing sea isn't a place to be caught unprepared.
Okay, you know.
You have to find Virgil. A renegade Institute scientist could finally give us the insight we need.
All right.
The memory den's not accepting new clients right now, sweetheart.
Why not?
Irma.
Oh, enjoying yourself in Good Neighbor? It's a heck of a town, ain't it? You like the decor? My business partner hates it. Says she's not the fun type.
I wanna do another memory thingy. Why can't I do this? He looks like that guy from The Matrix. What's his face? It's all over, but the crying. It's all over.
You got the memory pod loaded up? Oh, you're not Irma.
Hey there.
Good Neighbor's crazy. Thefts, murders, worse. Sometimes you just got to escape a little to make it through the day.
I hear you. It's a mess out there.
It's rough in the best of days. But now, you ever listen to the Silver Shroud? That's what we need. No matter how bleak things got, he saved the day.
Silver Shroud. Oh, I listened to it pre-roll.
I used to listen to every new episode.
You mean when they first aired? How? The last broadcast was hundreds of years ago.
I'm from the past.
I was in cryogenic storage for a long time. I only just woke up.
Oh man, that's amazing! You're just like Mr. Abominable from episode 83.
Wasn't he a caveman?
Yeah, that's the one. They found him in an iceberg off the harbor. Boy, if you just woke up, the world these days must take some getting used to.
It seems the world sucks. People are finally rebuilding and recovering from the nuclear war.
Maybe in some parts, like Diamond City, but over here, we got a ways to go. I got a question for you. What if the Silver Shroud was real, with his black trench coat and gleaming silver submachine gun? I got a plan to bring him to life, so he can fight bad guys and give the rest of us a symbol of something better.
A plan?
What plan?
I've built my own custom machine gun, even better than the one in the show. But to make this work, I still need the most important piece. The genuine Silver Shroud costume herself. And they got one here in Boston. They made it for the TV show. Will you help?
I guess I'll get it.
I'll get the costume for you.
You're gonna do this? For real? Before the bombs fell, they were filming the Silver Shroud pilot over at Hubris Comics.
Okay.
So that's where you'll find it. You're the best.
No problem, buddy. Paladin dance. Paladin.
Nick.
Hope you got what you were looking for inside my head. I was right. I should have killed you when you were on ice.
What? What
did you say? What? What are you talking about?
You sound like...
You sounded like Kellogg just then.
Did I? Huh. Mari said there might be some mnemonic impressions left over. Anyway, I feel fine, so let's get going. Or I could head back to Diamond City, since you've got company already.
Take Nick, or keep Paladin there.
We have to head into the Glowing Sea. Any advice?
I'm a synth, so radiation isn't much of an issue for me, but an old suit of power armor might just be the guardian angel you're looking for. That, or you could buy up all the Rad-X and Rad-Away you can find from any chem dealer who's got it in stock.
I will take... I'm gonna take Paladin Dance.
Good luck out there. You know where to find me.
Where do I find you?
Hey, Valentine.
Time to hit the road?
You interested in traveling together?
Sure. Could be fun.
Not now.
Well, I'll be around if you change your mind.
Where? Where the fuck? Is he gonna stay here, or? I think he's heading back to Diamond City. That's where they all go. So. Let's head over to the Glowing Sea. Where is that? That is quite the walk. I would need like another fusion core. Or, even better, I think I can take a vertebrate. And that's it. What I want to do. That's what I will have to do to be able to make it in the power armor. I don't think I could walk that distance without my stupid fusion core running out. At least, that's what I think.
Let me ask you something.
Get the fuck out of my way! Ask away.
Ask away.
It's just, with everything that's happened with you and your family, it's a whole hell of a lot to process. I wanted to make sure you're holding up all right.
See, you're so cool.
Yeah, I'm all right.
Huh. You're a tougher nut than I thought. Tougher than I was. Took
what
me
do
a
you
long
mean?
Damn time to get a feel for this place. Thank goodness I found Diamond City. It's got its flaws, sure, but it beats the hell out of anywhere else in the Commonwealth. Of course, when I took up there back when, people were just as scared of the Institute as they are now. Maybe more. The massacre of the CPG was still pretty fresh in people's minds at that point. And folks were still losing sleep over the broken mask.
What does that mean?
Plenty of people assumed I was just a saboteur, moving in to melt down the reactor or poison the drinking water. But at the time, they couldn't exactly turn me away.
Broken mask?
Broken mask?
This was long before I'd moved to town, but apparently some gentleman type shows up in Diamond City, heads down to Power Noodles. Guess he didn't like the food because he pulled his pistol and opened fire on the folks enjoying theirs. When security finally put enough holes in him to drop him, they say he was full of servos and sprockets. Just like yours truly.
Seems just he like malfunctioned you. And
went berserk. It was the first time people realized that synths had stopped looking like me and started looking like them. Considering what these folks went through, I felt real lucky they let me in the front gate at all.
Massacre of the CPG? What's that?
The Commonwealth Provisional Government. Years back, a group of settlements tried to get together and form a coalition. Every settlement with even a hint of clout sent representatives to try and hash out an agreement. Only the Institute sent a representative of their own, a synth.
Holy crap.
Every rep at the talks. The Commonwealth Provisional Government was over before it even got off the ground. I took up in town not long after. I was damn lucky they didn't just tell me to scram right then and there.
They let you in?
Because I'd rescued the mayor's daughter. Gal of about 15. Pride and joy of the mayor back then. Man by the name of Henry Roberts. The young Miss Roberts decided she'd run off with some caravan hand she'd, known for an evening. Turns out the guy was part of a gang of kidnappers. I didn't even know who I was rescuing. Just stumbled on a crying girl and four toughs. I took her home and the mayor dubbed me a hero. Offered me a place in town. Lots of folks protested, said I was a spy, but he wouldn't have it. Taking up in the city was tricky at first, but I never tried to hide what I was.
Huh.
People seemed to warm to that.
You took down four guys?
You took down four guys by yourself?
Well, I didn't have to. Back then, synths were even more of an unknown quantity than they are today. I told them I was rigged to explode and started going beep, beep. The hardest part of that rescue was keeping from laughing as they climbed over each other to get away.
So you're not a spy.
You're not a spy, right? Testing, testing, hello, Institute, can you hear me?
If I am, the Institute's plan to gather intel on all the runaways of the Commonwealth has been going off without a hitch.
Was it hard?
See, he doesn't even know.
Yeah, they sure didn't make it easy. I started off doing the jobs no one else wanted. Got more banged up being Diamond City's handyman than I ever did living out in the ruins. But I guess folks never forgot I rescued the mayor's daughter, so they started coming to me when people went missing. Wife runs off with a new paramour and takes the rent money with her. Talk to the synth. An upset father decides moving him and the kids to Good Neighbor in the dead of night's not the worst damn idea since the bomb. Go get Nick. After a while, the jobs got so backed up, they didn't even ask me to do the handyman stuff anymore. Hell, I was so happy to do it, it was months before I started charging anyone. I never stopped being Nick the Synth, but it was Nick the Detective folks came to see. It was about then that things finally started feeling normal. It took me a long time to realize that home is where you make it. And with some time and effort, this
nice.
Can be home for you, too.
Nick is fucking story, awesome.
But I hope it helps. Want to get moving?
How come you don't love Nick? He's even better than a human. Just because he's not a real human. So what? So what? He's got his own AI. Look how smart he is. Alright. So, let's head outside. This bad boy.
Don't let all that feels like you can take on the world in there, doesn't it?
I guess. Whoa. The Earth has been visited by an alien species in this location. These Zaydens are said to be armed with power-up beams. They can completely disintegrate enemies. Hey, it's Alien Blaster. That looks really cool. I love the new artwork. Fun. A portable naval cannon? Like the things on the warships? Those huge guns? Whoa. Holy crap. Look how cool he looks. What the fuck? Mind all over this bitch. What in the world are they doing here? Hunter's Flamer. Oh, sweet. Super Mutant's Order. Cool. Brotherhood!
Mission accomplished.
Can I, hitch a ride with you guys? These guys are fucking cool. Okay, I'm gonna try and go somewhere a little bit more cleared out. like, we'll go here, because I know it's safe here. Look at this cool sniper. I was thinking of getting rid of my pipe bolt sniper. Cause it's not that great. Oh, ring! We are back. Let me get out of my power armor. Save that fusion core. We're gonna need it. And then he gave me these vertebrate signal grenades. A vertebrate has been sent to your location. See if this works. Calling in vertebrates. Alright, let's see. That's really stupid that you can't recharge these cores. Like, it would be cool if you could make like a charging station. Where it would take a little bit of time. Board the bird. Alright, I'm coming. To go. Can we move a marker? And then, oh, can we only go here? I want to go there. Take me. Oh, you can't. Fuck. That sucks. I was hoping you could do that. Damn, I wasted this then. Cause I don't have anything other than that. Fort Strong. We took Fort Strong. Okay, so this is all water. The map is still pretty big. So we can't go like there, like, I wanna go here. Go. Damn, that sucks. I was really hoping I'd be able to do that. Where can they take me? Certain lakes that don't show up until you find them. I'm gonna say for this, We can head over to Hardware Town, I guess. Oh, I guess we can't. Damn, that sucks.
Reading all clear, green for takeoff. Your minigun should be loaded and ready to fire. Good shooting, sir.
What if I wanna go here? I'm not gonna walk around in that. So I need. Hello there. You're a guard.
Hey there.
Too many miles on the road. At least the pay is terrible.
Where is your leader? The caravan expert.
Hey.
Maxon might appear compassionate, but I can assure you the Institute will face his wrath.
Oh.
Can't talk right now. Gotta clean the Mire Lurk scat off my boots.
Sucks to be you. I'm gonna put the radio on so I can have something to listen to. Damn, this fusion core is not gonna last me. I don't think it's gonna last me to walk there. And I forgot what happens when you run out. You still move, but slowly. Dance loves it. See how fast that core goes down? I haven't checked if Bethesda has said anything about a patch coming, or if they don't give a shit. There better be a patch. There will. There'll be a patch. We have tons of .38 shells. Oh great, the highway that you would use to get there is kind of broken. And by kind of, I mean very broken. Alright, let's pick our steps. Mucho arigato. I like that robot of the Diamond City, the Japanese one. That's the only thing he says. One word. Aturata. I forget what he says. He only says one thing, but I can't remember what he says. Oh, minor larks. Hey, just passing through. No need to get all pissy. Oh, fuck. Let's go around. I don't feel like dealing with them. Gotta keep an eye on that fusion core down there. We're almost at 50%. And we're not even there yet. At least the Pip-Boy is instantaneous. No waiting for my arm to come up to my face. None of that. You walk underwater? That's cool. Well, that would make sense. This offers like serious red protection. Hey, it's one of the... At least it's sunny. There's always that. She said nearly nothing can survive. So hopefully nothing will be alive when we get through this, what does she call it? The Yellow Sea or something? Glowing Sea. That's what she calls it. That weird name. What a strange name. I hope we don't run into Deathclaws. Or those ones that can turn invisible, apparently. It was all fun and games until it wasn't that much fun. And it wasn't really a game. Mucho arigato. What's that? Forklift? We're almost there. And I haven't run into Deathclaws. Mutsu arigatsu. Okay. I wish there was something that could increase the duration of the fusion core. I keep talking about it because it's really important. No, beautiful. We had to make that whole wall. Okay, there are definitely radiation rads. Please, please let everything be dead. Oh yeah, everything looks dead. Not even trees. The trees are all dead. That means the Deathclaw should be dead too. What is that? Oh, I thought that was a red scorpion. I'm like, no freaking way. They can withstand a lot, but apparently this is like crazy amounts of radiation. Wow, this suit really is doing the trick. Ha ha ha! There you go, there's your little guide. Easiest way to get through this was a suit, apparently. Whoa. Please. Please let nothing be alive. Everything's dead. How could anything survive? Wait a minute. In the trailer there was a Deathclaw and he was in a hazy yellow place. Does anybody else think There's a deathclaw out here. Blood bug. How are you alive?
Something I'd like to discuss with you.
Not right now.
Very well, it can wait.
Not right now, boy. We're trying to not die of radiation poisoning, remember?
That song was, Hold On, it was by Three Sons.
Oh yeah, definitely saw the Deathclaw here in the trailer. She lied when she said everything would be dead. I don't want to fucking deal with blowflies. Can you deal with them? I just want to get there. Fighting these guys takes my power core level down.
Where'd they go?
Right there, you stupid dumbass. Just leave me alone.
No one knows if everyone involved died or not. Probably though. That's usually how these things. Just another day in the Commonwealth, am I right?
Kill him. Let's go. I am not getting any younger here. Proving your manliness. More killing things that need to be dealt with. When we need to deal with them. Oh yeah. Yep. I can see the Deathclaw now. This is freaking scary. We're at like less than 50. Almost there. I'm scared. Watch out for death claws. They'll ruin the day. Oh yeah, we are deep. Sorry, but we have to keep moving. I can't keep going like this. Not with my pistol. Lava? Damn, this place is irradiated. I wonder how many rads there are right now. 40? 50? Ghoulies. I'll just take my chance. Or we could just not shoot them. They seem to be fine with not shooting us. Nearly there. Almost there, almost. How the hell did this guy get through? He had to have a suit as well, or some kind of institute thing. If he's even human. Crater of the Atom. How the hell do they survive?
Atom will lead us all to glorious division.
Hey there.
May Atom bless you with his glow.
Who the hell?
Stop right there, stranger. You approach Atom's holy ground. Why? State your purpose or be divided in his sight.
Holy ground? Atom? What's going on here?
Atom reached out and touched this world, bringing his glow to us. It remains to this day a reminder of his promise. Infinite worlds through division.
What is this place?
This is where we commune with Atom himself. I am surprised you have survived long enough to reach it.
I'm looking for someone named Virgil.
Virgil? Yes. We know this Virgil.
I can't imagine anything can survive in this radiant zone.
I need to speak with you.
What do you need of me, child?
How the hell are you alive? Radiation?
How have you survived all this radiation?
That is Adam's unique gift to us, true believers. He has brought us here to this place. A place that cannot harm us.
Can you give
so
me red resistance?
We may worship him. So that we may spread his word to others. That is our calling, to deliver Atom's message to a world that does not wish to hear it, to show Atom's power to all.
Do you have a moment?
What do you need of me, child?
Virgil.
I'm looking for someone named Virgil. Have you seen him?
Yes, I know of him. What do you want with him?
I just need some information from him.
He has sought refuge with Atom. I would know more before I tell you where he is. What do you want with him?
I just need some information from him.
He has sought refuge. What do you want with
him? I need his help reaching the Institute.
I have heard of this Institute. They hide themselves, trying to avoid the power of Atom. A futile effort, in truth. This Virgil has caused some concern. Some believe his presence is an affront to Atom. Though he came to trade with us on a few occasions, we have had little other contact with him. It was quite clear he wanted to be left alone. You can find him southwest of the crater, living in a cave. I would approach cautiously were I you. I feel he does not want visitors.
Oh, he's not here. Okay. Oh, we're outside the map. Son of a bitch, we're not gonna make it. Thought he was fucking here. What a disappointment.
The Great Divide comes.
Hey.
May the glow of Atom guide your path.
Alright, crazy rated people. Nearly 25%. Nearly completely through with it.
It sounds like from what I
Then what? Then the radiation resistance turns off and I die out here? That's what it feels like. And then I can't just get out of this. I'm stuck in it. I'm stuck in this suit.
Just another day in the Commonwealth, am I right? Right? That's the worst thing about asking that question. No one ever answers.
Where are these fucking guys? I know, we have people worry about. If my fucking character could hit anything. Oh man. Yeah, they are. Can you deal with them, please? I think that using AP really depletes my core fast. That's what it seems like. Oh. Oh, beautiful. Things just got way, way better. No radiation protection. I'll die. Oh my god. That thing is huge. It's just one. Oh my god. How do I deal with this? I don't even know where to start. Damn it, I gave him my freaking Fat Man. It is, I think, literally. Why? You wanna go play?
Don't let it get close.
Oh. Yeah, you let it get close. Oh no. Oh, whatever. You know what? No one loves you. That's what they told me. That's what they said to me. They said, we hate you, Mr. Deathclaw. No one wants to be your friend. Just so you know it. Oh crap, that's gonna explode, that's gonna explode, that's gonna explode. Suck on it. Better not be more. How the hell did we survive that? dumb luck. I just had... Can I not get up here? Oh, scared me. Please tell me there's no more radiation. And please tell me I could teleport out of here. I mean, fast travel. There's no more radiation. We're getting out.
Hold it. Take it nice and slow. No sudden moves. I know you're from the Institute. So where's Kellogg, huh? Trying to sneak up on me while you distract me? It's not going to work. I'm not stupid. I knew they'd send him after me.
Take it easy. Kellogg's dead.
Dead? He's dead. Don't you lie to me.
I'm not lying. I killed him myself.
Did you? Kellogg was ruthless. There's a reason the Institute used him to do their dirty work for so many years. I knew they'd send him after me. Tried to prepare for it.
Ah, he's a mutant.
Still wasn't sure I'd make it. And so you killed him, eh? Then what do you want with me?
Why did you leave the Institute? I know you came from there.
You know about the escape? But how? No, it doesn't matter. I'm not going back. I can't go back. Look at me. Why are you even here? What do you want?
Stop whining.
Relax. I just need to know how to get in there.
Wait, what? Are you serious? You want to get into the Institute? Are you insane? Never mind how nearly impossible that is. Even if you were to succeed, it'd almost certainly end in your immediate death. What reason could you possibly have for taking that kind of risk?
My son.
The Institute kidnapped him.
Oh no. I had no idea. I'm sorry. Yeah. The Institute has taken people from the Commonwealth in the past. If your son is one of them, I can understand why you'd want to get in there. I can help, but I'm going to need something in return.
What do you want from me?
Before I had to escape, I was working on a serum that would serve as a cure for my condition. I wasn't able to bring it with me. It's still in my lab, and... Well, look at me. I need it. I need you to find it for me if you manage to get inside the Institute. What do you say?
You help me, and I'll help you.
All right. Let's talk details. First things first. You know how synths get in and out of the Institute?
Yeah, they use some sort of teleporter.
Well. Not many know about it. Pretty closely guarded secret. You've certainly done your homework. It's commonly referred to as the molecular relay. I don't understand all the science behind it, but it works. Dematerializes you in one place, rematerializes you in another. I'm sure it sounds crazy, but it's a reality. The relay is the only way in and out of the Institute. You understand?
The only one.
That means you're going to have to use it.
How now, do I get one?
Have you ever seen an Institute courser?
A courser?
A courser? What's that?
Another Institute secret. Coursers are Institute synths designed for one purpose. They're hunters. Operations go wrong, a synth goes missing, and a courser is dispatched. They're very good at what they do. And you're going to have to kill one.
How am I gonna know which one it is?
Why do I have to kill one?
Because you want to get into the Institute. Remember? They're your ticket in. Every courser has special hardware that gives them a direct connection to the relay in the Institute. It's embedded in a chip in their heads. You need that chip. But to get it, you'll have to find a courser. Now, I don't know exactly where you can find one. They haven't sent any after me. And sitting here waiting doesn't seem like a good plan. You're going to have to hunt one down. I can tell you where to start and give you some help finding one. But you'll have to do the dirty work.
What do I do?
What do I need to do?
Listen up. The primary insertion point for coursers is in the ruins of CIT, directly above the Institute. So you'll want to head there. Now, the relay causes some pretty heavy interference all across the EM spectrum. You've got a radio on that Pip-Boy, right? When you get to the ruins, tune it to the lower end of the band and listen in. You'll be able to hear the interference. Follow the signal, and it'll lead you to a courser. Then, you just have to not get killed. Not gonna lie. The odds aren't in your favor here. But if you do make it, remember what I said about the serum. I need it badly. I really do hope you find what you're looking for.
I see. We made it through the glowing sea, just barely. Let's see. 40% more damage. Level 16. Let's see. Automatic weapons do. And work much more quickly. Seems like kind of important. Travel to CIT.
Protect and serve. Protect and serve.
I love the new protect rounds. It looks so cool. We're making some progress here. Oops. Well, I didn't mean to do that.
Good luck finding a courser chip. You're gonna need it.
Hi.
You find a courser, don't underestimate it.
So, courser is what they're called. I should check on my own settlement. That's what I'll do. But the prime. Okay. Over, but the crime. There's so much radiation. It's crazy. Okay, so we're going this way. And then we should be able to finish real back. If not, well, then we're dead.
Time to suit up.
You bet your ass. I don't think you can fast travel from here. Yep. Very little radiation, less than one. Plymouth Rock would land on them. Every time you level up, your health increases and you get to choose a new perk. Increases strength. Incoming damage is reduced. Taking damage recharges action point. Energy damage. Nope, I don't have any of that. Alright, looks like still a while. New comments, there are none. Seems like no one's really been watching. Stop it. No.
They were last seen attacking for
success until someone threatened their life.
That's fine.
Me? I'm very successful.
I guess maybe they're
hey.
Take over.
Ready. Do you want to have that talk now?
That's an improvement, right?
Of course.
What's on your mind?
Thank you. This isn't a formal meeting. I simply want to clear the air. I think we may have gotten off on the wrong foot when we first met, and I feel like I owe you an apology. Expecting you to embrace the standards of the Brotherhood without having a history with us was... I think I needed to push so hard.
That's very kind. Thank you.
Well, you deserve it. When I was an initiate, my sponsor was Paladin Krieg, toughest squad leader I ever served with. He was a model soldier, embodying the values every trainee was striving to achieve. Fiercely loyal, secure in his beliefs, and brave to a fault. From the moment I was assigned to his squad, I was singled out. It felt like he was pushing me harder than the rest of the team. I fought by his side for years, and we had some seriously close calls. But he never explained to me why I was treated that way.
Did you ever ask him why?
I'd considered it. But unfortunately, I never had the chance. After I was promoted to Paladin, and I'd moved on to my own squad, I received word that Krieg was killed at Adams Air Force Base. The news was like being kicked in the stomach. I mean, I'd lost some of my brothers and sisters before, but his death... well, it really got to me. It's taken me a long time to realize it. But the reason Krieg was so tough on me...
Krieg
is the same reason I'm so tough on you. It's because I believe in you. And I don't want to see any of your potential go to waste.
What happened at Adams Air Force Base?
Back in the capital wasteland, the Brotherhood was at war with a traitorous group of rebels who called themselves the Enclave. They maintained a mobile command post at the remains of Adams Air Force Base.
Oh, that's right. We blew that shit to Kingdom Come.
The Brotherhood spearheaded an assault on the command post, which was ultimately successful, but costly. Quite a few soldiers died in that battle, and Paladin Krieg was among them.
I was only like...
He made his mark on history. And whether you choose to believe it or not, you have the potential to do the same.
I was like the only one there. I mean, the vault dweller.
I'm flattered that you have so much faith in me.
You've earned that faith by your own hand. Well, I've said what I had to say, and I hope that it meant something to you. I trust you'll keep this in confidence, of course. Some of that information was of a personal nature, and, well, I'd like to keep it that way.
Where? I need the guy who works here. I guess she can work this. This resource is not awesome.
What have you got to trade today?
Using settlement. we can. Look, 11 billion, you can build stories. Learn the name and show.
We should make good time when the weather is clear.
And scrolls. Oops, I still have that damn. Oh. Wait, what?
Let me know if there's anything I can do to lighten the load.
Go to the workstation.
No, if you need anything proofread.
How do I go to the workstation storage?
Yeah.
What does that mean, the settlement's workbench? Where is that? Oh, this? You mean... Hey, we made 28 bottle caps. You can store all the junk. Let me. Alright. That's pretty cool. You can store junk that you don't need.
I'm afraid I'm not much use in a fight anymore. But back in the day, folks used to call me Murphy Mabley.
There's six people, but not enough beds. Alright, we can make some beds. Furniture, bedding. Make some simple beds. I don't give a shit where they sleep.
That was Butcher Pete by Roy Brown. Not the other way around.
And we need
now the
defense
another,
is going down.
Sense.
Why is that?
That have happened. That, I don't know, maybe you hadn't already heard about.
I
sounds
say,
like from
where are we
what
headed?
I,
nothing
heard.
Stays hidden forever.
People saying in the bar.
Not if I have my say.
There was a, I guess. It was some sort of chem's deal. Like, selling them or something. And it went bad. Gunshots. People dead. That whole shebang. It's unclear whether... I mean, no one knows if everyone involved died or not. Probably, though, that's usually how these things go. Just,
Copper.
Just another day in the Commonwealth, am I right? Right? That's the worst thing about asking that question. No one ever answers.
Some nuclear material.
Skeeter.
Laser standard sights. There's a weapons.
Really creative today.
A little bit. It's the end of the world. That's pretty cute. Adhesive gear and oil. I never have what we need. I need to go and pick up anything and then come back. Oh, I'm so close. Damn. Like, I'm so close.
I should have done more. I hope those raiders pay for what they've done.
And then, reduce range, improve recoil. Poor range. What do I need for that? I just need adhesive, damn. Oh boy. Duct tape, that's adhesive. Yeah, I just need more of that. Jeez. Store all the junk I can. Let's go and pick up a lot of stuff and then just store it. I like that. It's a nice little detail. I'm picking up all this crap. A whiskey. Our little settlement. This is my old house.
Nice day. Where are we heading?
Nowhere. You stay there. We will so take this. Turn it into something kind of useful. Kind of. I think I'm getting better at the game. At least a little bit.
Give me a laser rifle and my power armor, and I'll take on the world.
Okay, whatever you say, buddy. I don't need the dress, but I'll take the baba pants in a day. Give me those suckers. An oil can. Some bricks. Surprise, we haven't just destroyed this place and taken everything. That's what we should be doing. But we're not. I need some kind of adhesive. There's gotta be more tape around here. Tape seems to be everywhere. Adjustable wrench. Eat bagels. Can you put as much as you want in the workbench? That would be really convenient. I think you can. I'm having fun. Out of an orange colored sky. Dude, X, Zams. I'm still ones. We need to make caps. We'll see. Thinking about it. Crawl out through the fallout. Dog meat's not here, I don't think.
You remind me of a young man I used to know. Never looking for trouble, but always finding it.
I'd just leave that if I were you.
This is not junk, my friend.
Our little sanctuary revival project has really helped. It takes my mind off things.
Coffee pot. Damn.
Maybe constantly trying to kill us, but the Commonwealth never lacks for safety.
Huh?
At least it's not raining.
Hey, Carla.
Need to pick something up? Road's pretty long from here.
What kind of stuff do you have?
Just
everything. You'd be surprised what people leave behind on the old roads. Gotta keep your eyes peeled for good stuff. Got plenty to sell if you're interested.
How do you set up a supply run?
Let's see what you have.
Let's see. Electromagnetic cartridge. What does that mean?
Some days are harder than others. But even the hard days get easier than the one before.
Totally not thought that. Well, they thought he might be dead. Or destroyed, or whatever. Anyway. Glad you're back, Nick.
Got plenty of stuff.
Ever. Here we go, some Bob Crosby.
I took a bunch of this stuff because I wanted
in here who's lost someone. I miss him so much.
I think you should stay on point. Your instincts seem to be right on target.
try to make myself useful. No one wants to see a grown man feeling sorry for himself. Huh?
Building something?
Yes? Yeah.
I can do? You just say the word.
Yeah?
Oh, I'm supposed to do that. I'm really tired. There we go.
What have you got to trade today?
She ain't talking all that shit now. Giddy up, buttercup. Oops, sorry.
Whole lot of shit.
Cooking.
A lot of it. Yep. That was,
weapons. I can't make him do stuff.
Stay sharp. Don't let your guard down. Need something? Things are tough now, but they'll get better.
Rocket 69, Rocket 69. Samba, Rocket is ready to fly. What else can I buy? Might as well scrap that. Have no use for that piece of shit log. What we should do is, I'll drop this off first.
I say, where are we headed?
Nowhere.
Yeah.
Remember, we're out here representing the Brotherhood. Let's make them proud.
Yeah. Well, I keep doing that. 7 bottle caps. Let's go Red Rocket. I'm gonna go to Diamond City and pick up Futter's face. I'll just tell Power Suit Boy here to go back. What are you doing? What are you doing, dog meat?
Boy!
Everything okay, boy?
What's going on here?
Come on, boy. It's time to go.
And then we'll send him to Sanctuary.
I doubt this canine can match my tactical prowess in battle, but it's your decision.
Okay.
Heads up.
He's not making any whimpers, though.
Heads up. How you doing, buddy? Stay safe, buddy. Codsworth.
Shall I accompany you, sir?
Would you like to?
As you wish, sir.
Yes, of course.
Lead the way, sir.
Look alive.
Sir?
Over here.
My pleasure.
Look alive.
Yes, sir.
Hey, Codsworth.
Another is already in the works.
It's time for you to head home.
Right then, sir. You know where I'll be should you require anything.
Tell us apart.
I'm gonna have to take the fusion core. Beautiful. I have no fusion core. Where'd he go? I wish the map told me where my companions were. He was right here. There you are.
Nick.
Time to hit the road?
Let's head out.
Well, all right.
I like having you around better than the big boy over there.
I hope you find your son.
A lot of people out here could use a hand.
Dude, you're so cool.
Maybe constantly trying to kill us, but the Commonwealth never lacks for excitement. Nothing stays hidden forever. At least, not if I have my say.
Huh?
Codsworth.
Shall I accompany you, sir?
No, not now.
All right, then.
There's 7 people. Well, we're running low on resources. I think I have something here.
Such a positive guy.
There you go. Seems to be growing well.
Potato plant.
You're listening to,
there you are.
Some Betty Hutton, if you were waiting to hear it. I mean, whether you listen or not, if you're Betty
Hutton. Where is Fuckface?
I want to chit chat.
Kind of.
You ask me, freedom's always worth fighting for.
Aren't you the patriot? Alright, I think I'm gonna end the stream.